Suddenly, a unicorn screamed softly and pointed at the police officers. As one, the audience turned and McNab found himself the main focus of an army of insanely smiling giant soft toys. He tried to find the words he needed to say. "This is a police raid, everyone stay in your seats," but they stuck in his throat. Several of the theatre-goers were now on their feet. One bizarre creature, McNab assumed it to be a hedgehog, although it was covered with pricks of a very different kind to those found on its woodland cousins, buzzed menacingly, in contrast to its incongruously rosy apple-cheeked smile, and made a run for the door. McNab finally found his voice. "Stay where you are! We are police officers!" The audience, rather than stay where they were, followed the hedgehog's lead and stampeded for the double doors, only to find them locked. In the centre of the mass of panicking furry bodies, a large tiger, adorable in every aspect except for its giant rubber penis, tried to force its way through to the door. A key held high above its costumed head. But it was no use. The press of bodies was just too great. McNab reached for his radio. "All units employed on Operation St. Trinians, I repeat, all units employed on Operation St. Trinians, make your way to the drama studio at the rear of the school now, and I mean now. Stop anyone from leaving the building." Realising they were caught like rats or piglets or ducklings or even plush lobsters in a trap, the audience began to wail and moan. Several seemed to faint, but most just fell to the floor in a dejected heap or retook their seats. The dancers climbed down off the stage and joined their furry friends. "Who's in charge here?" demanded McNab. The tiger walked forward, pulling off its head as it came near.
"That would be me, officer," said Joan Bultitude.